afternoon baseball now from the desert southwest and Chase Field here in downtown Phoenix. Today, in high definition, it's an exhibition matchup between the Boston Red Sox and the Arizona Diamondbacks. Jeff Pulse will be on the mound to face them. And this is a guy that needs to establish the inside part of the plate because his stuff is such that he'll have a hard time getting by if he doesn't mix in location well. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Well, most scouts rate players' attributes on a 20 to 80 scale.
He'll try again, 1-2. And a fastball blew it right by him and they're two down.
Yeah.
Here's another 2-2. Struck him out, so he makes quick work of him here. Three straight strikeouts, and the side is retired. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. We'll come right back with more from Chase Field following this. Harry Potter will stand in here, looking to keep the inning alive with two gone now in the top of the second. Now the 2-2 pitch. Up the middle, and it's going to get into center field. It's a two-out hit.
Mission accomplished there with two away.
Clay Brannon will stand in now. He'll likely have a look down to third to see if anything's up here with nobody out. Liner towards short, and this will get over his outstretched glove. A great effort there, but it's a base hit. And the runner will hold at second, so two on with nobody out.
Good start to the inning here as back-to-back singles have him in a good position to push across that first run of the afternoon.
Oh, this is hit hard towards second, but this will be taken in at second base. Good positioning for the first down.
With a long
now, seven strikeouts as this is swung on and missed for the second out.
Well, right now he is just carving them up, dare I say, like a Thanksgiving turkey.
Sure.
And he gets on top of this one and sends it on the ground to short. Throw on to first, and that error won't come back to haunt him after all as the inning is over. Greg Pulse will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth. Now here it comes. And he sends a fastball out to left field and fairly well hit. And this is into the bleachers in left, a home run. A solo shot here to left. As the Red Sox get the game's first run, it's 1-0. Tom Pulse will dig in with one in and one away. And on 3-2, he delivers a line drive out to left center. That's going to split the defenders out there for extra bases. And he's in there easily at second with a one-out double.
We'll get a good look at this.
Harry Potter will stand in. A base hit his first time around. Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way. And this ball gets down in front of Ross. It's a base hit. And they won't risk it at third, so they're at the corners now with only one away. Got him. And that's eight strikeouts now for him in the ballgame.
Not only has he rung up a lot of strikeouts, but he still hasn't walked a batter to this point, so his control has been really, really spot on so far.
struck him out. So double digits now, 10 strikeouts for him thus far. All right, folks, montage alert. Here you get a look at his performance so far, 10 strikeouts. And here's a ball hit in the air. King will put this one away and the side is retired. So put another zero on the board as they've been held scoreless through five. Five innings complete. The Red Sox on top, 6-0. And he struck him out. And there's strikeout number 11 in the ballgame.
And I'll tell you what, he's throwing with a lot of confidence right now. He's also taking some chances with location, but you know, he's thinking he's bulletproof out there, and so far he has been.
Swing and a ball headed towards the hole. Throw beats him by a half a step. He almost beat that out.
Good hustle getting down that line. Even on a routine ground ball, you can't take your...
Greg Pulse will stride in again, and you can bet he'd love to do again what he did back in the fourth. A solo home run here that's been the only long ball of the game so far. Swing and a hot shot toward third. And a perfect start to the seventh as this should be extra bases. The throw into second. And that is where the wheels pay off as he's able to make it into second with a hustle double.
Pretty safe to say he was sitting on...
Here comes another 0-2. He's just rolling right now. An even dozen strikeouts for him in the ballgame.
And here's a look at his pitches by inning so far. He's up to 8-2 now, so he's been able to keep that count fairly low and not run up too many high-stress innings.
And he swings on top and sends it on the ground out to second. A bare hand for one. On to first, it's a double play as their woes continue. The inning is over. Nothing doing for Arizona. They still find themselves down 6-0. Clay Brennan will try again. 2-for-4 in the ballgame. Oh, and he took a big swing at that one as this is driven out to deep left center field. And that ball is gone! Home run! So a solo shot here to left center field as this lead swells to 7-0.
This is just a fastball right here, but I'm pretty sure it's not where he wanted it. This has got some elevation to it, and that's one of those where you know it's going to be a home run as soon as you let go of it.
There's 7 1/3 innings now. They've just not been able to mount any type of offense against him at all.
And he's got another one. 13 strikeouts now, and the inning is over. Diamondbacks down in order. They're down by a touchdown, 7-0. Now here's the pitch. Struck him out as his woes continue, as that's his third strikeout of the game.
Well, this has been a thoroughly dominating performance out there. He's kept these guys guessing all game long, and he's just one out away now from picking up a well-deserved complete game shutout.
And he gets strike three called to end it here. And with that, this one is over.
Boy, what a performance of pitching that we just saw. He was so close to putting his name into the record books, but he's going to have to settle for that complete game one-hitter.
Look at the final line score there to see the great pitching performance that led his guys to the victory. can't win if you can't score, so there's probably not a whole lot of debate about who'll take home Topps Player of the Game honors in this one.
You have to figure he'll probably be replaying that one hit he allowed over and over in his mind tonight. Nevertheless, he was absolutely brilliant on the mound all throughout.